Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions once again, and welcome to a somewhat out of the ordinary video. This is going to be Christopher Does Terrain. I do have this box of terrain here, left over from I-Corps' Keltos line. This is actually currently manufactured by Brigade Models. I believe that's who has the licenses, or the license, to produce the Keltos line now. This is the Chevaux de Frise. I'm assuming, my French stinks, I'm assuming that means Wall of Spears. I do not know, though. French is not one of my three languages. So, but basically what you get is, let me see if I can pull this out here. There we are. Okay. You get a bunch of these little stake things here. I've got a miniature in there. That's actually not included with the kit. That was just an extra mini that I had laying around that I put in there back when I got this set a few years back. You get four sets of five spikes, or spears, or whatever we want to call these things. Really, really well detailed, well sculpted. You can see the wood grain in there. I mean, even without priming, without painting, it's really, really well done. And then on top of those four, you also get four resin bases. And these are fairly well done. They're going to require a little bit of work to get them to look really nice and to sit flat and things like that. But basically what you're looking at is something like that there. And so let's go ahead and get started. This is going to be, like I said, sort of an odd video. I'm not going to do step-by-step tutorials. I'm just going to show you guys little bits as we go, and hopefully we can knock this whole thing out in one video, maybe two. All right, so I'll be back in just a second with a little bit more advanced version of what you see in front of you. Just as a quick note, a good tool to have around is a pair of really heavy-duty diagonal pliers. These work great for cutting larger chunks of metal off of a sprue, a metallic sprue anyway. And it just makes life so much easier. See how easy that clipped off? So it's just, like I said, great tool to have around. Not quite as light as sprue cutters. You're also not supposed to use sprue cutters to cut metal. It will dull them. Good pair of real heavy-duty diagonal pliers, though. Great tool to have in your toolbox. As you can see, I've gone ahead and assembled the four pieces of the spear wall here. To do that, I used just basic cyanoacrylate glue. This is like super glue, but it's a little bit stronger. I like to use the gap filling. It dries in about 5 to 10 seconds. But basically, at this point, all I got to do is start priming these guys, and then we'll be ready to paint. Okay, the primer has dried on all of the spear things here. And I'm going to go ahead and put on the undercoat, or the base coat, I guess is what I should call it. And I'm going to be using I guess I should explain what I'm doing first. I'm going to start off working on the spikes themselves. The reason that I'm doing it that way, instead of doing my base first like I normally do, is since these are implanted in the ground, it's okay when I come back and dry brush the base to get a little bit of that dirt color on the spikes. However, because I'm going to be dry brushing the spikes, if I had done the base first, the base would look stupid because it would have the spike color dry brushed onto it. And so, in this instance, it's going to be okay for me to do things out of the order that I would normally do them. I'm going to be using a size 2 brush from Winsor & Newton Series 7. You can see this is a fairly long brush, or a long bristled brush, I guess I should say. And it works fairly well, though. I'm just going to get some color here. The color that I'm using is this right here. I'm using Burnt Umber from Vallejo Model Color. It's just a really, really nice dark brown. It's got a little bit of gray mixed into it, and it works really well for doing the bark of trees. All right. So, I'm going to start out, and basically, this is really easy. Whenever you've got a long area like this, use a bigger brush and just make a couple of long, smooth strokes. And you can basically cover the whole thing within about 15 seconds. Okay? So it works really, really well. And you'll notice that I'm not turning the piece at all. I'm simply painting what's in a row right here in front of me. This is a great technique to use for painting armies. because you won't be spinning the miniature around as much. You'll paint everything that you can see at one time, and then you'll turn the mini around and paint everything you can see when you spin him. Alright, so for instance, I've done everything that I can see on the top here, so now I'll simply spin it over and paint the underside using the exact same technique. Okay. And don't worry if you get anything on the base, or I guess I should say I'm not worried if I get anything on the base, because it's going to get covered up here in a few minutes anyway. But for right now, just continue to work around this. And my paint is very thin for this particular purpose. I want to be able to see all of those details in the bark of the spears here. And so I'm using really thin paint because I don't want to fill those in. And so this is probably going to require more than one coat of paint. Alright, and there we go. Just like that, the whole thing's done. Very quick, very simple. Let me show you what it looks like once it dries. Let me zoom in real quick here. Alright. And you can see, hopefully anyway, you can see all those nice little grainy details and things like that. And you can also see that I'm probably going to have to coat them again because you don't have a very uniform color, which is fine. Don't have a problem doing that. But sometimes when you paint with thinner paint, just realize you're going to have to do at least two coats, sometimes even three. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and recoat all three of these other ones that I've already done. And once that is done, we'll come back and we'll actually start highlighting the stakes.